Hey guys, this is me Hardik. Welcome to iGeek's blog. I'm here to increase productivity of your iPhone. I have 7 hacks for you which are very simple, very easy, and they are gonna uncomplicate your life. So the first feature which I want to talk about is the text replacement feature. So usually there are people who have this habit of using a phrase multiple times or share a particular detail multiple times to multiple other people, like your bank details. So text replacement is the thing for you. Just go to settings, from there go to general, there select keyboards, then text replacements. Now you can see the plus symbol on the top. You click that, you add a phrase and a shortcut and save it. Your job is done. So now whenever you want to share your bank details with someone, you just need to type in bank and your details will automatically appear on your keyboard. Another cool feature which I find very productive is drag and drop of a message. Now let's say you need to copy and paste a message from iMessage to Notes. So you just hold that message and then you drag it from your iMessage to your Notes app. And that way, you can easily transfer your messages from one app to another. You don't need to copy paste it, you just need to drag and drop it. The next feature actually surprises me because people around the world, they're talking about it, but then again, there is a certain bunch who has no idea that this simple yet basic yet productive feature is out there. I'm talking about setting up a timer straight from your control center. You just need to go to your control center, over there, select timer, and just drag your time, whatever time you need to select, and your job is done. Your timer is set. It's that easy. Are you someone who does not check their mails regularly or their social media regularly, but at the same time you cannot see those number of notifications or badges piling up that gives you anxiety attack, panic attack, that you know you need to check so many messages and you are not able to do it yet, and you cannot now sit and relax until unless each one of those badges are checked off? In that case, you need to turn off your badges. Just go to settings, select an app whose number of notifications or badges bother you, and then just turn the badges off. And as you can see, your job is done. Now, one thing we all are sick and tired of is giving app ratings and reviews. No matter what work you are doing, there will be a pop-up asking for your rating and your reviews. So I have a solution to that. You need to go to your settings. From there, you need to select App Store. Over there, you'll see an option of in-app ratings and reviews. You need to turn that off. And your job is done. You're welcome. Now, with that toggle off, no app is gonna bother you anymore. If you are someone who receives plenty of emails every day, this feature is for you. You just need to open your mailbox. Over there, you need to swipe left so that you can flag a mail. This way, you will know that this mail is important and you need to reply to it later on. And which mails are flagged, you can always see from the side menu. And if at all that mail is important for you, you have flagged it, but you still need a reminder to it, then just right swipe on it and put a reminder. With this, you'll never miss any important mails ever again. And since now you are receiving so many emails per day, you would want to watch a preview, right? So that you have an idea that you want to open that mail or not. Now, usually you get a two-line preview, but you can change this setting as well. You just need to go into settings, and from there, you need to select mail, and over there, select preview. Here you can select how many lines you want to see in a preview. And once that is done, you won't have to open your email ever again. I hope you will try these hacks and improve your productivity with your iPhone. Do send me a comment which one was your favorite. And also, don't forget to like this video. Apart from that, of course, goes without saying, you need to subscribe to iGeek's blog for more such content.